Okay, these, I can't believe this is blooming after only 2 years, but my 2-year-old seedling has bloomed. Awesome. Another one here, don't know what color that was gonna be, but anyway, I think I'm just gonna repot these two. It's not gonna hurt this one bit to remove a couple of those. And here's some new ones I got. That's Pink Surprise and Pink Flush right there. So look, these things will bloom with nothing. So I'm not worried about repotting the 2-year-old seedlings at all. Can you see already what the subject of my video is about? Can you see the bright orange or tangerine? That's the newest amaryllis bloom. It's a beautiful orange. I love it. It's got kind of a little bit of a burgundy undertones in the striping. I love it. This is seedling number 3. I have one more over here. Look, got another bloom coming. So I'm really excited about this. Just wanted to record this for the update video. Look at that color. I thought about going and getting, let me get a few more other flowers to compare. Two other orange flowers. This is from a canna, and I'm not real crazy about the color, but the canna is really tall and impressive, so I like it. This is a nasturtium. And I was just gonna compare the colors. Now, my amaryllis is definitely orange, but it kind of has a different tone to it that it makes me really like it a lot better. So just thought that was a neat observation. And I'm going to move these over here in more of a shady spot. Let's see, the light keeps taking over. And then move it back over here with the, there's an nasturtium right next to my amaryllis, and then the canna. I think I like the color of my amaryllis a lot better. Well, this is the newest seedling right here. This one turned out more red. You have to do like the little white. It has a little white pigtail. I really like that. Okay, now we have the update for the grow out. These are 2-year-old bulbs, amaryllis. And I'm going to sort these as well. Two of these, I moved them because they have blooms on them. But I think if these are gonna bloom, they will no matter what I do. You can just rip them out of the pot, they'll still bloom. So I'm gonna go ahead and sort these out, and I may not have so many of these. I'm going to keep some of the largest ones because I just don't have room to grow them on. I think if you put too many in one pot, it takes longer. As you can see, I have dug out the siblings of this one, and put one good one back in there. And I might let this one that's blooming grow by itself because I don't think there's room for another one in that. So the ones that were in here went into the selection. So let's hope all goes well. Well, I've got a much bigger production going on over here with the 2-year-old bulbs. Actually, two of my 2-year-old bulbs have bloomed, and I'm really thrilled about it. But these need to be sorted out. I think I had like 46, and I'm going to cut it down to about 24, maybe. Maybe 24, I'm not really sure yet. I'll just decide by how these look. Like, these all look like keepers. This one is right here. And that one looks really good. some of these are getting a little bit on the small side, like that one, but I might call those out. I'll just see what I have and keep the best ones, and these are the culls. These are the little ones that I don't want to mess with. This one will take forever to grow big enough to bloom, so I'm just going to get rid of these small ones and stick with the best ones. And I guess I better get busy, and I'll turn the camera back on when I decide what I'm going to keep. Okay, I've got the selection done. Now, all I gotta do is pot these up, and I've got the pots over here. I'm gonna put 3 in each pot, 24 are the biggest ones, 3 in each pot so they can grow, and hopefully next spring I will have some beautiful blooms waiting for me. They all look good. Some of them are really big, like this one's nice. Really nice one here too. And they needed to be repotted because they have a tendency to sink into pots. So you've got to, you know, lift them back up so that a third of the bulb is out of the soil. You don't want them to have rotting problems. And I got another surprise. Look at this. I've got another bloom coming. That is a bloom. And it won't hurt it one bit. It will bloom because it's using the energy that's in the bulb. So I'm not worried about that one bit. I'm just going to enjoy a third one. So I'll definitely be updating that. So I've got to get busy potting these up. And I did ditch a lot of them. I could plant these in my flower beds just to let them do their thing. And like I said earlier, I don't want to really mess with these. I just don't have room for all this. So anyway, really happy to have all these. It's like, to me, this is like almost free bulbs. So I'm really enjoying them. I've got to repot these year-old seedlings here. And you notice how I have kept the pot weeded out. You do have to feed your plants, give them good soil to grow in. Keep them weeded, don't let them compete with weeds. They will not do good. And then we have these little extra plants that I actually wanted to replant these somewhere else, so I didn't pull them out. Little coleus growing there. Anyway, I'm ready to repot, so I'm going to dump this pot out. I know this seems a little cruel, but I want to get the seedlings out of the pot without doing too much damage to them. And look at all these beautiful roots on these seedlings. Look at that. These are very healthy. I like seeing their root systems looking that good. So now you just want to divide them out, and you're going to cut the, I'm going to cut some of the tops off of some of these. So now you see we have these little baby bulblets. Look at that. Some of these are really tiny, undeveloped. I'm just not going to mess with those. I don't have the time or the space. But I'm going to pick a dozen of the biggest ones. Because blooms, amaryllis will bloom once it has enough storage of nutrients in the bulb to support blooming and seed making. And you're not really going to always want to get seeds. But you want plants that grow very well. Look at that one. Just a little miniature bulb. Check that out. It's really cute. This year I'm going to put them, I'm just going to get rid of these. And just don't have room to grow them all. I used to try to grow them all, and it's just not possible to, unless you have a lot of room, like a field or something, it's not possible to give every one of them what they need. So it's best just to grow what you can handle. So it's always better results. So I'm going to group these into four to a pot. And then get 3 3-gallon pots. So get these potted up and ready to go. And I'm going to trim the leaves off, and they're going to get off to a good start for their second year. I've prepared 3 3-gallon pots with some good quality potting soil and some tomato and vegetable fertilizer that I'm working in pretty good in the first 2 or 3 inches of the soil. because I want these bulbs to grow and put on some size this year. And possibly I may add, in a few more months, I might put some time release fertilizer to last them the rest of the whole year. So, but for now, we're starting out with just some cheap fertilizer. This is the Expert brand. As long as you mix it in really well, it should be fine, and it will help them put on some size. And they need to be in full sun too. They will not grow good if they're not in full sun. So I have my little selections here, 4 to a pot. Not crowding them will actually help you get earlier blooms as well. So here we go. Here's my 4 that goes in each one. I might just maybe mix them up a little bit so that, yeah, there we go. They're kind of assorted sizes now. Now, it's just, I'm leaving the roots on there. Oh, that's very funny. There's like a snail shell, the root going into the shell of the snail. That's very interesting, like it had attacked and killed the snail. Anyway, let's go ahead and get these planted. And I want these beautiful roots to be on there to get these plants off to a really good start. And these, like I said, you don't want to sink the whole bulb into the soil. These bulbs need to be a third of the way above the soil. And I'm going to take off some of the foliage too, because I'm going to get my clippers. On the back of my clippers, so I am going to cut the green off of this so I can plant them correctly without them falling over. Okay, I'm going to show you how to prepare the bulbs for planting. I'm just going to cut them an inch or two above like this. And you're going to give them, you know, the roots a little trim. You need those roots, so I don't want to trim the roots too short. So it should look about like that when you're done. So anyway, I'm going to start planting them. And you plant these just like you do amaryllis. A third of the bulb should be above the soil. And you don't want any air pockets underneath the roots when you plant these. So they should be sitting on top of the soil like this, with the roots extended like that. And they'll be happy like that. There we go. There are the bulbs sticking up. Perfect. Now, the last step is to give them all some water, including the little seeds I planted over here. And it's done. It's all done. Got these 2 pots of some good quality potting soil. It really does matter. You need to get good quality. Don't get any junk trash to plant these seeds in. And I've had good success, whether it had fertilizer or not, but if you're cautious, then maybe you could just add your own fertilizer later, but I don't think it matters. At least you'll see my results here. Here's the seeds I'm going to be planting. Okay, I always start out with the pot nearly full, and I want to take my Red Lion. These are from the Red Lion, crossed with the Apple Blossom. So I'm going to put a little bit, just kind of put the seeds about an inch apart. And I do like to kind of look and see if this is a good one. I don't know if it's going to show, but you need to see some substance to it. It's probably not a good seed. So I'm going to stir these around. These look good. These are really great looking seeds. Don't let them dry too long. They lose viability if you let them dry out too much. I'm going to get some from the other pot as well. And I might thin the seedlings just depending on what I see. If they're growing good or not. But I'm going to, you know, put them in a layer, but maybe an inch apart or something like that. I'm going to obviously be thinning them later, repotting them. And this is the same way I planted these. These are from Minerva right here. And I'm going to be repotting these too, because these are a year old. I know I'd like to see these in a minute, the Minerva seedlings. So let's get these planted. These are the Red Lion apple blossom crosses. So anyway, it looks like I've exhausted all the good looking seeds out of here. And I'm happy with that. They look good. Should get a good germination rate as well. So they're kind of spread out a thin layer. And then I want to put some, just a thin layer, of just enough to cover them, of more potting soil. Just enough to, you can't see them, you don't want them floating up and out of the pot. So there you go. And they kind of gently press to firm them into the soil. And like I just said, you don't want them to be floating out of the pot. So this is just about perfect. So now I gotta make my tag so I don't forget. This is the Red Lion cross with the apple blossom. And there it is. So now I'm gonna go ahead with the apple blossom plant cross with the Red Lion over here. Okay, just when you start to feel like, I guess they're not gonna sprout, here they are. So they look like this when they first come up. They'll come like little blades of grass. So that's an apple blossom cross with Red Lion that I planted 3 weeks ago. This is the Red Lion pod cross with apple blossom. They're up, so I'm going to let these grow. In my 8-week climate, I can just let these stay in this pot until next spring when I sort them out and pot up the strongest bulbs. So the cycle has started.